Let's take a look at this interesting problem on Reddit. The most challenging part of this model is creating this spiral groove. It has a helical path. This is complicated by the fact that the path is on a conical face. We will start with this cone. We first want to define the path of the groove. I have a sketch here that will help us in defining the top and bottom points of the path. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select the conical face as a face to split. For a splitting tool, click on the select box and select the sketch. Let's bring up these two sketches. This will serve as our sweep profile, while this will serve as a sweep path. Activate the surface workspace. Go to Create, Sweep. Select the horizontal line as a profile. For path, click on the select box and select the vertical line. To create the spiral effect, we need to add in a twist angle. For orientation, set to perpendicular. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select this face to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the swept surface. With this, we have successfully created a path for the groove. Activate a solid workspace. Go to Create, Pipe. Select the split line as a path. Set section to circular. Adjust the section size. For operation, set to join. We still need to cap off these ends with a dome. We can create a sketch to perform a revolve, but for the sake of convenience, I'm just going to use primitives. Go to Create, Sphere. Select this face. Step onto the center and adjust the diameter. Set the operation to join. Do the same for the other end. This is not going to be parametric in the sense that when you adjust the pipe diameter, the sphere diameter is not going to change accordingly. You will need to manually link the dimensions together by the use of parameters. Let's add a fillet. Go to Create, Pattern, Circular Pattern. For object type, set to Features. Go to the Timeline. Select the pipe, the two spheres, and the fillet. For axis, click on the select box and select the vertical axis. Adjust the quantity. For compute type, all three options will work in this case. Lastly, go to Modify, Shell. Select the base face. Adjust the thickness.